When it comes to weddings, everyone wants the perfect day. But unless you have unlimited funds, it's I do. But at what cost?
$3,000, Terri. Sorry for my language, no f***ing way.
I'm sorry, but you don't have a choice on this one.
Whoever wasn't diligent enough to reply by the date has now lost their opportunity.
You can't do that.
I'm serious. And I forgot the programs on the bus.
How did that happen? Neo is dead.
Oi.
She's very nice and clean.
Oh my God, what guy picks out their bride's dress?
Weddings are places to have family nearby. Weddings are a bride that can't help but cry. Weddings can leave you financially high and dry. Meet newlyweds Terri and Mio. Agreeing on their wedding plans meant disagreeing on just about everything else. Let's watch this couple duke it out and see if anything, including the budget, is left standing.
My name is Terri. I'm 27 years old and I'm a school teacher. My fiancé's name is Phil, but I call him Mio. We met at a party and it was love at first sight. This is the story of how we played tug of war with our budget all the way to the altar. Our wedding day was perfect.
Yeah, it really was though.
Thanks, Terri.
Oh, I'm supposed to say that?
Yes.
Thanks, baby.
Their wedding day may have been filled with perfect smiles, but getting there meant fighting tooth and nail. Let's set the clocks back and see how this couple managed to grin and bear it.
My expectations of the wedding planner were that I wanted her to take my side when we went to different places and save me from the budget man.
Enter wedding planner Anne-Marie Danielle Barker. Will her 12 years of experience be enough to persuade this couple to agree on anything?
I find that the bride and groom oftentimes have different vision, and it's my job to ensure that I can incorporate both visions for the day of the wedding and their expectations are met.
So, Terri, tell me about the vision.
Well, I want it to be really, really pretty, very elegant, romantic, a little girly, browns and pinks everywhere, and just really, really pretty.
Great. How many people are you expecting?
We're looking at about 160 right now.
160?
Yeah.
Your venue. Have you selected a venue as yet?
And I'm taking it that you did? The most beautiful venue ever. It's got high, gorgeous ceilings, and it's beautiful. It's gorgeous.
It's very beautiful, I must admit that, but it is way too pricey for us. It will not work.
I don't think it's too pricey.
So what are we gonna do?
Well, I took it upon myself to check out a couple other venues.
You went to some venues?
Uh-huh. Yes.
Without me?
Yes.
What?
I think I found something beautiful. And I think she's really, really gonna like it.
Okay.
It's got a lot of the same things that she's looking for. However, it's gonna be fitting our budget more appropriately.
I can't believe you did that.
It's not a big deal. So I'm trying to take some of the wedding stress off of you.
But I found the venue.
It's too expensive.
Okay. Well, I'm thinking maybe we can take a look at the venue and see what it looks like. See if it's going to work. And hopefully it has exactly what you're looking for. Let's hope. But it fits into the budget. So let's hope.
You're going to kind of have to because I already made an appointment.
Neo, how could you do that without me?
Well, I looked in your schedule book. I saw when you were available, so I made the appointment.
Okay, so then it doesn't hurt if we were to take a look at it.
I'll look, but I'm not making any promises.
No, that's fine. You don't have to. You're going to walk in and be like, oh, this is so lovely.
Okay, we'll see.
Okay.
She will.
And you love it?
Oh, absolutely.
So what's the dress like? Have you got the dress yet?
I'm very particular, and I like things a certain way, so my lips are sealed.
Ah. So let's talk flowers. So what are we talking about in terms of colors?
I love calla lilies, fresh, beautiful calla lilies, and I hope to have them everywhere. I think it's a gorgeous, elegant flower.
Right, that's true.
It's a quite expensive flower, however, it's worth it.
And I see it as being very, very realistically and close to the budget and cheap.
And cheap.
Cheap.
As in very cheap.
Not very cheap. There's some things you gotta splurge on. I understand this is her one day and her last day of getting married, so it needs to be on board with whatever I have as well.
My major source of stress in this wedding is Mio. Unfortunately, he has really tight constraints on me, and he really wants to stick to this budget, and it's really stressing me out because I can't.
So tell me a little bit about your cake.
I want a beautiful four-tiered big cake with calla lilies on it, pink, brown, maybe a brown ribbon around it. I want it in the center of my head table, a nice center beautiful piece.
Right. Okay, so you're looking for something that is very, very outrageous, beautiful, but at the
same time,
popping.
Simple and elegant, but popping.
Right, yeah. Okay.
That's money out the window, Terri. The real...
For a cake? That's part of a wedding.
No one's gonna eat it.
People do eat cake at the wedding.
Yes.
And they want to take it home, too.
Yes.
Okay.
Sometimes they take home, you can box the cake, or you can serve the cake.
If we get a real cake, we'll box it, put a little thank you card on it. Those are our favors.
Absolutely not. We need favors to give to the guests, and it's not going to be
cake.
Then
you need to pick between favors and a cake, because I'm not having both.
We're having both.
Take a look around you. These are all trees. Until these trees grow money on them, you're not having both.
We'll see about that.
Okay. Well, why don't we talk a bit about who's paying?
Yeah, let's talk about who's paying.
Who's paying?
Well, my family is giving us a portion.
Okay, well, that helps a lot.
And where's the rest of the portion coming from?
Where's the rest of the portion coming from?
From my back pocket.
Okay.
Which means my wallet is not too thick.
It can be for the wedding. It's gonna have to be, I mean.
I think the major source of conflict on this wedding is definitely gonna be the way she wants to dress everything up. It's true, you never get a second chance to make a first impression. I totally understand that. But when it comes to spending money ridiculously in areas just for the one day, just for a setup so people can walk in there and be like, oh, how nice, how beautiful. Myself, it's not worth it. Terri, she'll probably stop at nothing, and I'll be that brick wall she runs into.
So we've got the colors so far. So we've got 160 guests. Mm-hmm. We've got the church. We're still working on the venue. Everything seems to be coming along well so far, but the cake we've got to do, and everything's going to be great. But what's the budget?
Well,
remember, it's I do, but at what cost?
We're going to make it work. All right, so let's get working.
Coming up.
This is not what I want. Does this look like a happy bride?
My nemesis from high school was there. She actually came and helped serve the meal so she could get a look at the husband. And I'm like, look at me now, look at me now.
When it comes to your wedding plans, be prepared for some explosive conversations.
Okay, so you're looking for something that is outrageous.
That's money out the window, Terri. The real...
For a cake? That's part of a wedding.
No one's gonna eat it.
And soon, we'll let you know if all this spending led to a wedding that was a real blast.
I had a venue in mind that I wanted so bad, and it was perfect and beautiful. And of course, my dreams of that venue were crushed when budget man came in and said, no, it's too expensive. So he went out and found this venue without me.
It had a lot of the same features that your dream venue had, just in a smaller version.
Right, smaller version.
Did I do good or what? Just got high ceilings, big enough dance floor, balcony up top. We could take some nice pictures over there. It's a cozy feel. It's small enough. What do you think?
What about this wall? Is there anything that we could put on this wall?
Well, we don't really have anything to put, but to be honest with you, not too many guests really notice that.
Really?
First of all, they're here for you.
Yeah.
They're here to have as much fun as they can have.
Well, if you wanted to draw away from that, I mean, you have four trees at the back wall there.
Definitely.
Can we not maybe take two of them?
Definitely.
Yeah. Prop
that
one
can
up
be
our
put.
Side?
That can be put. That's not a problem because those trees are movable. We can move them.
Okay, that would help a little.
Okay. Yep. Why don't we talk about colors? What are you looking at in terms of colors? You think it's going to work with the room so far? So
what kind of linens do you offer? What colors?
Basically, we have three colors: black tablecloths, white tablecloths, and ivory tablecloths.
No. Brown tablecloths?
No. You would be able to bring your own linen.
Bring in linens from where?
From an outside source.
Why would you go outside to get linens when they provide linens for us?
Because the colors, they're black, white, and ivory.
What's wrong with black, white, or ivory?
But that's
three to
that's not
from.
Our color. The other venue has these things already incorporated into it.
For my wallet, this fits us way better.
If you're going to be saving costs on getting this hall, then I need to do up this hall the way that's going to suit our wedding.
The fact that they already provide some stuff, now you already want to start taking it out, that's not practical. The money that we save here can be used in other areas. I don't think...
Like linens?
No.
Maybe when you see what's behind the door number one, maybe you're going to change your mind.
Let's All see. Right.
Oh, gosh. Maybe it's a husband who's not afraid to spend money.
It better be a brand new car.
Maybe this is going to sell the hall.
Oh, wow.
Surprise.
Now look at this.
All right. Oh, this I like. This I really, really like.
The other venue did not even have this.
But what happens if a lot of guests end up coming out here and staying out here?
Well, that's a concern. We don't want to draw the guests out here when everything is going on the inside.
Definitely a concern, but this is something that can be managed by your MC. Yes.
Okay, I really like the patio.
Now it is licensed.
I like it. I think it's
yes,
a big feature.
It is licensed, and your guests can have drinks on a patio as well.
Theo, is this going to work for you, think?
I'm definitely loving the patio.
So you've decided. We've decided on this venue. We're going to go
sold.
And think about it.
I'm sold.
Okay.
Yes.
One in there for you, eh? Great.
But I think I did a good job when I went out and found another venue similar to the most expensive one at a ridiculously cheaper price.
Yes, you did a good job, but you took my perfect venue away from me.
But I found a small one and we made it just as perfect.
All right, I'll give you that.
Thank you.
I really wanted Mio to see how beautiful the flowers were that I picked out.
It was just a big day in the park for you. Decor means money.
My centerpiece?
Okay.
It's really big.
Those are gorgeous. I love it. It's gorgeous.
It's too tall, though. That's going to be taller than some of our guests.
That's the whole point, Mio. I want it to be beautiful and big and elaborate. I love it. It's perfect. It's like a showpiece.
Hey, you're sitting at the table. You gotta like, can you pass the butter or something like that?
No,
like,
you're sitting. No. Imagine you're sitting. Look,
actually,
like this.
Okay.
Look, you can see the person on the other side.
Dude, seriously, this is a friggin' tree.
But I don't see any money growing on it.
It's beautiful.
I think everybody's gonna fight for that.
We're giving that thing away?
You give away the table centers.
Well, maybe we should sell them at the wedding.
No.
Sell them.
Well, look at it. How much is that thing?
What does
that's
it matter?
Actually worth $65.
That's good.
And you're going to give away how many of these?
For each table, so 20.
I think the wheels are turning.
You're going to give away $1,300 worth of flowers.
No, it's the table centers. You have to.
Come on.
It's not a matter of giving it away.
Yeah,
it's how nice they're going to look. And people will remember this. This is the classiest setup of flowers that I have ever seen.
I'm not knocking how beautiful it looks.
I told you if you were getting this venue, I was decorating it the way that I wanted.
Okay,
that was really important.
Now I'm definitely regretting never picking that venue.
Oh, it's only money.
Yeah.
Easy to say when it's not yours.
We can always go to a grocery store and see what they have centerpieces for $10.
No, I don't want to get that cheap. Like, these come with a lifetime warranty? Are they going to die in 3 days?
They're not plastic. They're real.
I don't know. It just seems too much.
Come on.
Be happy. They're beautiful.
They are beautiful, but it's so expensive. I don't know yet.
Is that better?
Maybe.
Okay.
I'll think about it.
Thank you.
I better get a dinner out of this.
How about 20 dinners? One for each table.
When I saw those centerpieces and how grand they were, I would have paid more for those flowers.
See, there you go again. You already got a good deal, and now you want to pay more for something you already own for cheaper.
I'm just trying to explain to you how beautiful they were.
I get the point, and everyone else does, but you just proved my point to a T.
Theo took me to go dress shopping. I was meeting up with my mom and a couple of my girls. And surprise, surprise, Budget Man decided to burst in and think that he could pick out my dress. What are you doing?
Going in the store.
You're not coming in the store.
This is all about the budget and no. I'm going in there.
Mio,
I want to see what you guys have on
my. Go back in the car. You cannot come. You cannot see the dresses. Are you kidding me? See ya.
Come on.
No, Mio, you're not coming in the store.
Look, I'm going to be a gentleman and open the door
no,
for you.
No, there's no way. You are mad.
Dan, don't be so upset. What are you doing?
It says, remove your shoes.
It should say, remove your wallet.
Hello.
What are you doing here?
and help the girls out.
No.
What for?
You can't
we don't
come
need
in and pick out her dress.
Seriously, you've got to go.
Bye.
This is not a place for you.
There's the thrill of the surprise when she comes down.
Exactly.
I'm not one for surprises. Never have been. I never will be. So.
No, Mio.
Mio, bad luck.
It's not bad luck.
Yes, it is.
That's me seeing her the day before the wedding.
You can't be here. You need to go.
I'm not going.
This is insane.
Bye,
Mio. This is unheard of.
Bye.
We love you, but you've got to go.
Yeah, you got to go.
You've got to go.
Looking at this price tag, you think I'm going to walk out that door?
I have never heard of this before.
Do you have a discount rack?
Oh, my gosh. No.
Well, I have a value area, yeah, that has some gowns that are discontinued samples that are on sale prices.
Where's this rack?
We're all at the front where you passed it when you came in, just towards the front there.
Mio, I will give you 10 minutes in here. That's it. And then you're gone.
What happens if I pick it out in 10 minutes?
I'm not guaranteeing that that's going to be the dress. Actually, it probably won't be. Cover me.
Go, Terri.
I think that Mio cares what I look like on that day. He really does have a vision of my dress, but I think he cares way more about how much the dress is going to cost.
Ma'am, I thought you said these were discounted.
Oh, my God.
Regular prices are up to $1,500 and sometimes more on some of these dresses, so they're reasonable.
Jeez, I don't think so.
Are you serious?
Oh, no way.
Not that bad.
$200,
no.
Mio?
No.
Mio, these are all poof. Poof is out.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
That's a size 20.
20?
20?
Size 20.
Yeah, but you can alter it.
I think his time is up.
No, you can't alter that.
Why can't you alter
it? I'm not buying a size 20 wedding dress and altering it.
I think she's going to want to alter you.
Bye, Mio.
You guys are ruining my dress shopping experience.
It's not your experience.
No, stand beside
this
that.
This is not nice.
Just stand beside it.
This is poofy. This is not what I want.
Does
this look like a happy bride? Oh, my God. What guy picks out their bride's dress?
Okay, if I'm not picking out your dress, I'm picking out your budget.
I'm getting my perfect vision of my dress. That's what I'm getting. I don't care what the cost is.
I do care what the cost is.
Mio, this is once in
it's
a lifetime.
It's my dress.
It's going to take us a lifetime to pay back
it
this once in a lifetime.
Yes,
it will.
It will not.
Okay, let's go. Come on.
Terri.
Let's go for coffee. And then let her. Just let her.
Bye. Bye, Mio. Okay.
Terri, budget. Come on. Budget.
What budget did he set for you?
Oh, he'd be happy with 200.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah.
But like I said, I'm going to add a little one in front of that.
That's about average.
That's my budget.
Yeah, right. So what kind of dress are you looking for?
Actually, what I want is basically what he's saying.
What he was saying.
I just ain't letting him know that that's what I'm getting. I absolutely 100% loved my dress.
I'm not surprised at all that the style was similar to how I thought it would be. I mean, great minds do think alike, and I think he hit a home run on that one.
Coming up,
we have the grand prize winners. Congratulations, investors.
My mother's family baked our cake for us. It was a four-tier cake. I don't even know if we got
to
taste it.
44 tiers.
When it comes to weddings, remember that elegance doesn't come cheap.
These come with a lifetime warranty? Are they going to die in 3 days?
Be happy. They're beautiful.
They are beautiful, but it's so expensive.
And at the end of the show, we'll let you know if this couple spent real dollars to get their wedding right.
The linens were so important to me. I had to have my colors in there, so they were really important.
First of all, do you have a color scheme in mind?
Definitely. I'm looking for chocolate browns.
Okay,
and
perfect.
Pink.
Ooh, nice combo. And so there's this pink.
Okay, that's nice, yeah.
That's like a silk.
Yep.
We have this pink. Satin pink.
Too pink?
Yeah,
too
it's bubblegum pink.
Okay. I like this one, really.
Yeah.
I like this one. So
nice
you could put
sheen.
An overlay on top of this.
Oh, you can, yes.
Oh, okay.
Can we try that?
We can do anything you want.
As long as you pay for it.
It's your day.
Yes,
and
it is. It's my day?
Sorry.
Yes.
Oops.
You got it, Mary.
Oh, look at that.
It's not too girly, like.
I think there's an issue with the tablecloth. I think there's an issue with the overlay. I think there's an issue with the chair cover. I think there's an issue with that little funny Rambo-looking
What's
thing.
What's the issue
there's
with it?
There's an issue with the napkins.
They're gorgeous.
I don't want pink. And that's
pink
fine.
Is our color.
No, then you don't need to be putting too much pink in there. It's going to
look
there's
like
a
not. Sissy
venue.
That's the whole point of this.
No, no, the overlay really tones
it
down. Like I said, without the overlay, it would be a big splash of pink.
Yeah. Okay, so why don't we get to the prices and then we can decide what's going to happen here.
Okay, so if we went with the chargers with the double napkin and the bow, you're probably looking around
$3,000 for everything.
For everything?
$3,000, Terri.
What's wrong with that?
That's $3,000 more than we need to spend on stuff. The venue includes this stuff.
They don't have any of this stuff, and this is what I want.
And what are we supposed to do with the stuff after? Who are we gonna sell it to?
I'm not selling it, it's to rent.
To rent them?
What, you think that we were buying them?
For $3,000, I better be keeping them.
Well, how about a sublet?
Mio, okay, look, this is what I wanted. This is the only thing that I really cared about was
the
linens.
No, it's not. The only thing that left that I got to choose was the walls.
The venue, that's the biggest thing. You got to choose the venue.
Not spending $3,000 on this stuff. No way. Sorry for my language, no f***ing way.
How about being sorry for your cheapness?
If we were to actually eliminate items,
yeah.
Give me a ballpark figure what we're looking at.
The basics I would keep. Chair cover.
Okay.
A napkin I would definitely keep. And
take away the charger.
And take away the accessories.
So then what are we looking at?
You're looking at 18.
$1,800.
Sold.
I'm not doing it.
I'm sorry, but you don't have a choice on this one. I'm getting these.
Uh-oh, you've been told.
I want these
you
basics.
You want the color.
I want the brown. Okay. I want the pink. This is what we're going with.
We're writing it up.
We're done.
Okay.
I knew that no matter what it took, I was gonna get those linens. And I did.
Well, you know, it's a little soft spot, so let's not talk about it no more.
All right.
Pink and brown. Terri always enters us in these contests, you know? But this one was actually a wedding contest, so I thought, you know what, I'm gonna go along with it, and if we win it, then there's no money coming out of our pockets to pay for this wedding.
See?
And one day we just got a call from the radio station, and it was downhill from there.
And guys, as you know, this weekend we had the 4th annual Win a Dream Wedding Competition. Well, joining us now in studio, we have the grand prize winners. Congratulate Terri and Phil!
Yeah!
Hey,
guys!
Congratulations, guys.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
You have won so many things, including an incredible Mayan Riviera honeymoon. You've got a diamond ring. You're even going to get some cosmetic surgery. How are you feeling about that?
Incredible.
It's lots of words.
Shaking. Amazing. Awesome.
I know you're going to have an amazing honeymoon, but I'm curious about the cosmetic surgery. Have you thought at all about who's going to get what done?
Do I need anything, honey?
Nothing.
Oh, I'm going good. Answers.
Guys, congratulations and best of luck.
Tremendous. Winning the contest didn't help that much with the budget. It was a nice added bonus, but you surely made up for it.
In other ways.
You know, winning the plastic surgery thing was kind of cool. I mean, we discussed what we were going to do with it, and I think she's beautiful just the way she is.
Thank
you. I opted to use it for myself for a little problem area that I had.
Hey guys, how you doing?
Hi, good, how are you?
Nice to see you.
You too.
How are you?
All set?
All set.
All right. Okay, so you're a good looking guy, but you're gonna look even better looking without the double chin. But should basically Dr. Yaz will take out all the pinchable fat?
I'm a little nervous, you know? Of course, you're gonna be put to sleep. You don't know what can happen. I'm not too worried about it. I'm more anxious to get the actual procedure over with and then looking forward to those results. Chisel chin, baby, chisel chin. I wouldn't do it again. You know, that's for sure. I definitely wouldn't have paid for it. I've only
did it. Of course you wouldn't have.
Yeah, it's only because we won it. It was pretty nerve-wracking. Glad that's over with.
Mio was sick in bed, and we needed to get the cake done, so I had Emery bring the cakes to us.
Look at that!
Isn't that gorgeous? Come on, Phil, you have to admit, this is
actually
gorgeous.
You know what? That's not a bad-looking cake.
No, it's not!
Hey, wedding cake! It's so cute.
Cutest little thing ever.
They're fancy-looking, I must admit that.
So you're thinking dollar signs and...
Well, of course.
I bet the price is just as fancy.
This one is actually the white cake with raspberry filling and white chocolate.
That is so good. I think I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's a nice-tasting cake.
Yeah?
But... how much does a nice tasting cake like this cost?
You're talking about $700-$800.
For a cake?
Yes. Remember, you're looking for a four-tier cake, right?
Am I right?
Yeah,
am I correct?
Tiers, yeah.
Four tiers.
Our cake isn't going to be about this big.
But no one's gonna even eat it. $800 on a cake is a little too much. That's ridiculous.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
So how much do you want to pay for the cake?
It's about $200.
We can't get $200? The cake that we want for $200.
Then you know what you're gonna get? You're gonna get just
a slab.
Exactly.
I want the whole cake for $200, not just one layer.
But you can have the whole cake for $200. What is that gonna add to your presentation?
Doesn't matter about presentations. There's gonna be so much more food on that dessert
table. Really?
No, the cake is sitting in front of the head table for the whole wedding.
Listen, your big vision of this whole wedding is gonna put us in the poorhouse once it's all done. I'm not going over 200. You know what? I'll even be nice. 250.
You know what?
I'm not going over 250.
I understand what you're saying in terms of budget. That is clear in my mind. Budget all the way through. Now you, in terms of presentation, having the cake so people can eat it, I see that viewpoint as well.
That is very important.
So we need to find a balance here, and we need to figure out what we're gonna do. I can try see if I can find you a cake at that price point, but I really can't guarantee you what you're gonna get. You get what you pay for.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't need to be elaborate.
Yes, it does. It needs to be very elegant and beautiful.
Listen, the only thing that needs to be elegant and beautiful at the head table is you.
Aw, well, doesn't that just take the cake?
All right, if you want a cake for $250, I'll leave it in Emery's hands to find the most beautiful cake you can for $250. However, if this is not my beautiful dream cake and people are noticing this at the wedding, I'll lead them right to you who chose the cake.
$250 was not gonna cut it for the cake. So I told Emery that she could spend a little bit more if need be. And we got our beautiful calla lily cake.
Coming up.
If they can't show us a respect enough to reply by a certain date, then they're not coming.
They didn't want to give us the time off.
So I quit my job. But then during the honeymoon, I was thinking of, oh, gee, I gotta find a new job.
When organizing your wedding, it's a good idea to make a list of your concerns.
I think there's an issue with the tablecloth. I think there's an issue with the overlay. I think there's an issue with the chair cover. I think there's an issue with that little funny Rambo-looking
What's
thing.
What's the issue
there's
with it?
And at the end of the show, we'll find out if listening to Mio's concerns left Terri with a financial headache.
So we had a meeting with Anne-Marie to talk about how the wedding planning was coming along, mm-hmm. and we ended up getting into guest numbers, which was a little bit of a problem.
First of all, why don't we talk about the numbers?
Okay.
How many people have confirmed already?
We're at about 210.
210. Right now.
Just sold about another 30 of them invitations.
Another 30?
20 to 30 to still go.
Guys, the room capacity,
it's
200
not guys,
comfortably.
It's Terri.
Where will we seat these people? That's my question.
We'll find area in the hall. We'll put tables closer together or closer to the dance floor. Well, that's our guest list. That's how many we invited.
You don't get it. The hall only holds 200 comfortably. That's what we signed for on a contract. Not for 230,
well,
not for 240.
Well, that was our guest list, so what can we do? Look,
because you told me 20% of them would reply no.
I thought they would.
Well, you obviously thought wrong.
This is really gonna hit the budget big time.
I know that, I'm aware of
this
that, but
she's not.
This is
spending the budget up.
Oh, well.
A lot of things are gonna go up. The costs are going to increase a lot. Linens,
do
the chairs, the tables.
Well, what are you gonna
say? Extra table costs. Mio, we knew that these
it's
were our numbers.
It's not extra tablecloths. It's what? Chair covers, it's napkins, it's plates, it's more food.
We can only seat 200 comfortably.
I'm not paying for more people than I have to.
It's a huge concern, so we need to figure out another alternative. What are we going to do?
If you could call some of our guests and either de-invite them or not to show up with as many people.
No, we're not doing that.
Sorry. You're asking me to
de-invite people? No,
call
I'm not.
The guests and say they can't?
No.
Yes.
After they've already RSVP'd?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or the ones that haven't RSVP'd yet, uh-huh. we can give you their phone numbers and
de-invite them?
Yeah.
Mio, these are the people that we invited. We're sticking with these numbers.
As uncomfortable as this is for me, I'm here for you. And if you want me to call the guests and tell them they can come,
done.
I will do that.
We're gonna have to wait and see what numbers we get back.
Well, the budget is going over here.
I know
so
that.
So we need to control that.
Well, we need to control it in another way than disinviting people.
Well, let's put our heads together and figure out what we're gonna do with that. Are we prepared to spend more than what we really set out?
I'm not prepared to spend
for that.
I'm prepared for that.
Yeah, but is your budget?
Why are you always so quick to throw money out the window?
It's not throwing it out the window. You have to do what's right.
45 people cannot come. I'll even let you pick the people.
Before the uninviting began, they decided to go back to the venue and see if there wasn't a little extra room.
Okay, I am a little bit concerned for 240 people.
Oh,
how many are in here?
Here is set up for 209 people.
Okay.
This is 209.
This is not bad.
It is bad.
How are you gonna fit an extra 30 people in here?
You move everything, shift it, and you can fit three more tables in here. I can do it.
I'm sorry. Well, three tables you cannot fit. Don't forget that the staff has to move as well, carrying the tray, and the tray is pretty heavy.
Look, I see a lot of room for movement in here.
No, there's no movement. The only thing that's gonna be moved, there's tables out.
You guys gotta decide what you're gonna do.
Can we find a solution?
Yeah, do you invite
works?
Some people?
No,
that's it.
That's not a solution.
Yes, it is a solution.
No.
Whoever wasn't diligent enough to reply by the date has now lost their opportunity. This is not a joke here.
You can't do that.
I'm serious.
What if you're so like mean? Who are you?
I don't care who it is. If they can't show us the respect enough to reply by a certain date,
yeah, but
then they're not coming.
No.
Bottom line.
This one doesn't work that way.
Yes, it does
no,
work
it doesn't.
Like that. Yes,
no.
It does.
No.
Is this a wedding or military service?
You can't tell people not to come or invite their guests or boyfriends or girlfriends.
Yes. How would you feel if someone did that to you and said, hey, Mio, don't invite Terri? Wouldn't
That's
you?
That's different. I would have replied by the date. Well, now I'm going to be stuck taking care of this
that,
problem.
Mio.
No, you're not. Oh, no, you're not.
Stop. Stop.
I'm actually calling people.
You can't do that, Phil.
What are you going to say?
Watch.
No.
Why?
I'm going to do one. You listen, and you do the next one.
No. You can't be calling people to tell them not to come. That's just not
so
right.
I'm serious right now. I can't
what
believe
you. What's
up? What's up? Listen, for the wedding, you're coming solo, right? No. Okay, yeah, you gotta come by yourself.
No, you don't.
That yes, you do. Pat, just do me a favor. No, don't worry about looking for a date.
Looking for a date.
Okay?
Yes, you may.
Perfect.
Mio.
One down,
no.
39 more to go.
I can't believe that you had the gall to call someone and de-invite them.
It was all about getting stuff done.
That's not getting
yes,
stuff
it
done.
Yes, it was. It was one person off our list. You know, one day I'm just thinking about numbers and how much we're spending on this wedding and...
Like every day?
Yeah, and then you keep coming home and saying, I just spent this on this and I spent that on this and we need this for that. So I thought of a way to get some cash flow, so to speak.
No, I really don't want to sell the ring.
Terri, we got no use for it.
We have a use for it. I want to keep it.
The money's going to help us sell towards the wedding.
I'd rather have it.
Yeah, well, I'd rather sell it.
Sounds like somebody is putting their foot down.
You guys have something to sell?
Not yes, really.
Yes, we
do. Oh, you don't want to sell?
No, I don't.
We got it in the contest. It didn't cost us anything. And the money that we can get for this can go A, towards your linens, B, towards your flowers, C, towards some of the thing you ridiculously spend money over.
That's wedding budget stuff. We won this.
This
so
is
going to
help the
it.
Budget. No, this is going to help the budget. You don't need the ring, Terri.
We won it. It's free. I can use it. I want it.
Terri.
And it's how big? About a half carat?
Yes.
And how much were you hoping to get?
I'm looking for 3,000.
3,000? Wow. What's the least you would take?
2,900.
Half carat usually on the used market is between 5 and 1,500. That's the usual price of a half carat stone.
5 and 1,500? Yes. Neil, I want to keep that.
But this is a nice
that.
One, so this one wouldn't be the lower end. This would be the higher end. It would be a $1,500 half carat, but that's a very, very large amount for a half carat.
How about 2,000?
Oh, I can't, no. I'm already high at 1,500. You know, normally we would bargain, but I'm so high already.
I don't want to sell that for 1,500.
Well,
how much did you want to sell it for?
I want to keep it. I don't want to sell it.
Well, what do you want to keep it for?
To wear. I can change it into something else. Do you change jewelry?
Well,
I can get another half carat and make earrings.
Here you are again, figuring out more ways to spend more money.
I don't want to sell it for 15.
I think 1,500 is fair, too. We need to start paying some of the stuff back. Deal?
Okay, whatever.
Deal.
Okay, you have a deal. Congratulations.
I really, really, really did not want to sell that ring. It was a free diamond.
If you didn't spend money ridiculously in some places, I wouldn't have to sell it.
Oh, come on.
It's true. So I'm teaching you a lesson. You spend my money, I'm gonna sell your stuff.
Coming up.
Listen, I forgot the programs on the bus with the candles. She's gonna freak.
When I first saw Sheila coming down the aisle, she was beautiful.
Hmm.
And I was way too scared to run.
When planning a wedding, you may learn that two halves don't always make a whole lot of sense.
I don't want to sell that for 1,500.
Well,
how much did you want to sell it for?
I want to keep it. I don't want to sell it.
Well, what do you want to keep it for?
To wear.
And at the end of the show, we'll let you know if overspending left this couple completely broke.
The morning of the wedding, we fell behind at the hairdressers. It was chaos.
But I mean, now we can look back on it and laugh. I mean, I am.
Or maybe you can look back at it and cry.
Hey, Terri, we would like to have a toast to you.
Yay! Happy birthday!
To a great, cheers. Wonderful day.
Oh, Mio's on the phone.
Mio's on the phone.
Get off that phone. You cannot talk to her.
Okay. Terri, is everything paid for?
That's all he has to say to me?
Sorry, he's gotta go.
He's going to the chapel.
Guys, my eyes are so red from crying all day.
No! Makeup! Stop it! Stop it!
It seems the boys were too busy to shed any tears.
I don't even know what side it goes on.
On this side, no?
Not where the handkerchief is.
Left side, left side.
I think it's got to go there. Well, I'll take a vote. What side do you think it goes on?
It's the left side.
Opposite the handkerchief.
Yeah. I think it's opposite.
It's the left side.
No, that's right. Because then it's going to be too busy on this side, you know?
No, it's
so you're going to go right side, yeah. That's it. Yeah, right there. Right there.
Where are you?
No. Here, son. Here. Like this.
Listen to your father.
Yeah, just like that.
Phil, you didn't get instructions?
Didn't come with any instructions.
We're gonna miss the wedding over here.
Great, maybe Mio can uninvite you.
We'll do it at the church.
Okay, we'll do it at the church because it's gonna fall out.
From bridal suites to the reception hall. Luckily, you've got wedding planner Anne Marie on your side to take care of all of the other details. But time was ticking for our bride.
We're really late. I'm really freaking out.
Fine, don't worry.
Or Brittany, or Audrey, someone.
What is it? What do you need?
I really need my makeup case.
Okay, I'll go get it. Where is it?
Brittany's car. I don't know.
Brittany's car. Okay.
No, it should be just enough.
Too much. I'll have to pee.
Okay.
That's a disaster and a half there.
Well, okay. You need water.
Smile. Just keep a smile on your face.
Yeah. I will smile as soon as I get my makeup on. And then I'll be good to go. All right. This is not how I wanted this to go.
Meanwhile, the guys were doing what guys do best. Not a whole lot.
That's a big shooter bus.
I'll be like, this is class B. Bus, yeah, it is. You're a rock star.
Yeah, for one day only. It's all you can afford it for.
You ready, brother?
Ready to go, brother.
All right, go team.
Yeah, one, two, three, brother!
It all looked so easy for the guys until Mio realized he had forgotten an important detail.
Listen, I forgot the programs on the bus with the candles. Okay, as soon as the bus gets there, you gotta go on the bus and get them. Because I gotta have them here, like, right away. Man, she's gonna freak.
So we need to get the programs and the candles off the bus. That's on the way here.
I'm unbelievable. How did that happen?
I don't know.
Mio is dead.
Mio's fine. He has probably a lot to think about too.
It's okay. Not near as much as I do. I gave him two things.
Maybe it was one too many.
Oh, boy.
Funny thing was, I was walking off the bus. I'm like, do I have everything? And I was like, yeah, I got everything. You're cool. You're calm. You're, you know, put the jacket on. Get off the bus, say hi to the priest, you got the programs? No, they're on the bus. Starting to sweat now.
Where's the programs?
I think he has them in there.
So no one's taking them?
Yeah, I was told someone is gonna drive them back.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Don't worry, they're gonna get
them. Unbelievable. Can someone take a car and go? I need the programs there. The programs are still in there.
I'm going.
Terri, who's giving them out?
They're going to have to go down the pews now because people are probably sitting.
I spent so long on those programs, I would have been so mad if they didn't make it to the church on time.
I'm so lucky that they did.
The programs may have arrived in one piece, but Terri had arrived a little shaken.
It's okay.
Okay.
Come on, this one here can hold
okay.
Wow, the first time I laid eyes on you, it definitely got me choked up. I wouldn't go as far as saying tears were running down my face, but I did feel a little queasy inside.
Yeah, thought so. Hi, Terri.
take you, Mio, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
I, Mio, take you, Terri, to be my wife. I will love you all the days of my life.
That's not all day.
Oh, no.
I cannot believe we kissed at the wrong time.
I couldn't wait. No, I could not wait. I couldn't wait until he said, go for it.
I don't think he says, go for it.
Well, whatever he says, I just
We just wait. Took that upon ourselves and went for it.
I was following your lead.
Right.
I couldn't wait.
We're married!
Oh, stepping all over your dress.
Coming up.
I have some issues. I hate the head table.
When it comes to budgets, I'm definitely the person.
He comes from the gene pool of money people.
Exactly.
Unlike myself, so.
Spends it all.
When it comes to your wedding day, it's hard to remember every little thing.
Listen, I forgot the programs on the bus with the candles. Man, she's gonna freak.
Soon we'll reveal if this couple's budget became nothing but a faint memory.
When I first arrived at the hall, it took my breath away. It was perfect. I loved it. It was beautiful. But then I started to look around and I saw quite a few things that were wrong.
Oh,
I have some issues. I hate the head table. It's not supposed to look like that. But this I don't like. This is supposed to be suede. I don't like this. That looks horrible.
God.
Apparently, Terri wasn't the only one who felt things weren't perfect.
I'm not happy
Anything
with
else?
These centerpieces at all. They're like dying. That looks like
They're not fresh.
Yeah,
I want
the
to
tats.
Put a call in Taiwan for uh-huh. flowers and tell them I'm not happy with them at all.
Okay. Done. Thank
you. Anne-Marie leads the flower rescue and makes the call.
I'm having a bit of a issue with the floral arrangement. The bride and groom are not happy because they're a bit duped. The ends are dry. But what can we do about them now? Because he feels that they've paid a ton of money and they want to make sure that they have what they've paid for. So how are we going to be able to fix this? So is there anything you can do at this point in the game? We have the reception. People will be coming in for 5:30. Okay, thank you so much, Ron. Okay, great. Thanks a million.
The flowers were quickly replaced and the party was ready to begin.
A little bit of a snag. A couple people don't have seats in terms of the vendors. And we need to put in a table.
Hopefully Mio doesn't get word of this or he might send people home early.
Can we bring in a table somewhere?
Where?
I know. Let's take a look. I'm gonna make miracles happen, eh?
Yeah, it's the rubbish all day. Only thing that I can think of is basically sick to see them here.
Out here?
Yeah. So I can see them on the receiving table there or out here. How many of them?
I think it's two or three of them, I think.
Sure.
Thanks.
With a seat for everyone, dinner was served, and everyone had a blast.
This was the best day of my life, of our lives.
I meant to say that.
It was absolutely amazing.
I meant to say that,
It
too.
Could not have been better.
And I agree with that.
Good boy.
Good boy. But will you agree when you see the bill?
The original budget that we handed Anne-Marie was $30,000. I was really proud of myself for going and picking out those beautiful guest favors that were only $840.
I think Anne-Marie did a very good job on the day of the event, and her total fee was $1,600.
My beautiful pink and brown linens, I can't say enough about them, and neither could anybody at the wedding. They were well worth the $1,800 that we spent on them.
My wife looked absolutely incredible on our wedding day. Her dress was absolutely perfect in every way, and it was definitely worth the $2,174 that she spent on it.
The flowers were beautiful, and the centerpieces were absolutely amazing, just like I told Mio they would be. They were well worth the $2,600.
The venue came out really great. I'm so glad that I went there and booked it. I mean, the food, the service, everything was amazing, the alcohol. So it was well worth the $22,725 that we spent on it.
The miscellaneous costs, including the limo bus, videographer, and wedding cake, were $5,975. What we actually spent was $37,714.
Putting us over budget by $7,714.
Honey, I budgeted for $40,000. We're under.
You're not handling our checkbooks.
The bride was dipped, the crowd cheered on, and everyone danced the night away. The only question left is, will forgetting the programs haunt Mio forever?
What happened to programs, Mio? We need to talk about that.
Every year on our anniversary, we have to, you know, reenact the day, and we put on our music from our wedding.
Being the groom, what's the biggest thing a groom has to do? Is worry about showing up. He's not allowed to say yes or no or otherwise. It's yes and that's it.
Ah, that's gonna leave a mark.